percentage in our 10 islands.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In 2009, the Longhouse in Seo was lost to a devastating fire. The smoke from the blaze could be seen across the region, and the impact has been felt for the 12 years that our relatives have been without this critical home that is the center of our Saguenay culture. It is on the floor of this house where we practice sacred ceremony that have been passed from one generation to the next. It's where we come of age, celebrate and memorialize life. It's where we gather as families and as community. It's through ceremony that we learn of who we are as Huang'uk people, how we are connected to each other, how we are connected to our territory. And it's ceremony that breathes life into the laws and governance. When my relatives at Seo broke ground on their new longhouse last fall, they shared the deep loss that they have been feeling. But they did not only shed tears of sorrow of what might have been, they also were tears of joy for what will come when their new home is built. It was evident for all who attended the deep sense of hope, our CM, our elders and honored ones, that once again our beautiful culture will come alive within the walls of this new longhouse. In 2019, I had the honor of witnessing this in Weglisla when the Heytsuk Nation Big House was opened. It was a powerful experience. As Kuseot Elder and Councillor Mavis Underwood shared with me about the longhouse project, there is already incredible benefits for the community. Jobs and skills training for the young men who, on the site who are also experiencing the energy of having a hand in building this new home that will again invigorate the crucial link with culture, teachings, and our elders. Our Kuseot relatives are inviting the public to contribute to their new longhouse. And while they are nearly all there, they are raising funds to complete the project, and you can learn more at seout.ca/bighouse, TSAWOUT.ca/bighouse. I hope you'll join them in supporting this exciting project.